is. It's blowing out good underneath. It's way up yonder. No, I don't think it's that one. It's back behind that.
So Derek has busted a hose, and it's this one right here. It goes up, connects behind this filter back there on the block, which is no big deal. That's pretty easy there. But it runs over here and goes down in that abyss down there. Somewhere. And we can't move the machine. So this is where it's at. Right here. So if y'all ever want to see what it looks like down inside here. Yeah, it's going to go through that. It's going all the way to the back here. That line that is busted is way down in there. You can just barely touch it with your hand. What it's going to do is it's going to go underneath all that junk. You see that plate right there? It goes across. It's going to go through it. And Derek's working on getting back there behind the boom now. That's where he's working on trying to get to. And he's got it's not good. Not good. I wish they could figure out a little bit better way to route this stuff down through here, Derek. This is pretty bad here.
This is getting ready for the chainsaw class. There's the people who have been and see what all we do. They know the deal. It's a lot that goes on this. Probably a lot of people think that maybe the chainsaw class is just a thing. Come in and talk about chainsaws, maybe run them a little bit or something like that. But no, it's a lot more than that. I'm cutting up blocks right now for part of the class, and then here in a little bit you'll see some more. But the saw that I'm running right now is a 362, running it's a square ground chain on it that I hand filed with it. So now I've swapped to the 261 steel. This is still the M-tronic saw. All of them that I have are M-tronics. But what I'm doing now is I'm slabbing off these sticks, quite a few of them. These are what they call boring stations, and it usually takes several of them to get through a saw class, because we start out doing just regular boring, coming in with a saw just like you would bore through a stump, you know, filling a tree. Work from there doing that a little bit, and then I actually put lines on the face of it, and then you have to stay between the lines. And then we take it one more step further, and then we cut squares out of it. So I have speeded the video up right there. But the 261, it is going to be my least favorite out of the three steels that I got. It's a good saw, but I just can't get quite in love with it. There's quite a bit of difference between it and the 550 XP Mark II Husqvarna, and I will take the 550 XP a lot quicker than what I will take this saw right there. There are several things. I'm going to do a video and I'm going to run them against one another. The chain that I'm running right here in this one is a chain that came on the saw, and I have since taken it off. The chain that came on it was a semi-chisel. It was a safety chain, and I was like, you gotta be kidding me. But anyhow, and then still put a 63 gauge bar and chain on that saw. I know why they did that, but it's a little bit extreme in my opinion. And mainly is to get you to go back to the dealer to get a chain, because you're not going to find a 63 gauge chain in a 325 pitch just anywhere. But again, the saw is a good saw. I took the chain, got rid of the chain that was on it, and it's got a different set of dogs on it. Got dual dogs on it on each side of it now, three spike dogs. And I don't know, once I run it against the Husqvarna there and do some filming with it, I may end up doing some work on the muffler to it also there. But we'll see when we cross that bridge. I probably will not be keeping this saw. I'll probably let this saw go sometime this summer. I want to film with it a little bit, but if I just can't get where I really like it, I'm gonna let it go. But the 362, it's a pretty good saw. I liked it, but I like it even more now. I actually changed a muffler out on it this past weekend, and it made a huge difference on that 362. I mean, it really woke that saw up a lot. And I went back to a round file chain on the 362. Well, actually, this chain started off as a round file chain, then I filed it to a square file, and now I've done filed it back to a round file, and I'm going to go back, because what I'm doing is and you flip it and flop it that much like that, you get pretty good at the square file stuff by doing it like that, going back and forth. At least it makes me really have to work on it to get it right. Start ripping with a saw like this, it you can work them. It makes them work. It makes them earn their money anyhow. By this point in time, the old chain, it was starting to kind of want to give out on me a little bit, but I pushed on with it, got it going. Because if you're working on getting some time on a saw, this is a good way to do it. But again, the saw class, it's a lot to this stuff. It's not anything that's like halfway done or nothing like that. And I've got two classes coming up if you're interested in it. I got one this weekend. I got room in it. And then I got one next weekend on February the 13th. I got room in it too. It's kind of a a Friday evening, Friday night kind of deal, and start up about 6 o'clock at Friday evening. We work and run for a few hours, and then we adjourn and come back Saturday morning about 8 o'clock in the morning, and we roll. I mean, we go through everything. I mean, bars, chains, saw maintenance, just tons and tons of stuff. Talk about how to show you how to sharpen a saw, and we run. We do a lot of cut and burn, a lot of saw gas, and make a lot of chips, and it's a good time. My favorite thing about it is just getting to meet new people, you know, because I may have seen them in the comments, or may have you know, had some email communication with them, been on the phone with them a little bit too, and then to finally get to meet them is always pretty cool. And then there's a lot of friendships made too, because there's people that come from all over the place, and you know, like-minded people that want to run saws and want to learn about them and stuff like that. So, like I said, if you're interested in coming to it, my email is down below in the description box. So so hit me up and email me, and man, I can get you on in it this weekend or next weekend, either one.